Jersey's own Zach Gelb.
Or maybe it's Pennsylvania. Anyhow, it's one of the two, I'm pretty sure.
The Zach Gelb Show continues on Fox Sports 920 The Jersey.
All right, welcome back in. 5:15 is the time from the Princeton Orthopedic Associates Studios. We're all pumped up here in the city of brotherly love in Philadelphia as the Sixers have made a trade with the Celtics yesterday, and now the Sixers have the number one overall pick, and they will be selecting Markelle Fultz out of Washington coming up Thursday night. And now the Sixers have a trio with Joel Embiid, Ben Simmons, and then they'll add in the new guy in Markelle Fultz. We got to learn a little bit more about Markelle Fultz. And now joining us is actually Markelle Fultz's high school coach at DeMatha Catholic back when Fultz was a high school player, playing under the direction of one Mike Jones, who's kind enough to hop on board with us right now. Coach Jones, appreciate a few minutes. Thanks for the time. And how are you?
I'm doing great. How are you guys?
Well, I'm doing great, and the city of Philadelphia is getting ready to welcome in one of your former players. Let's learn a little bit more about him. When was the first time that you saw Markelle Fultz play basketball, and when did you know as a coach that this kid had something a little bit extra special in him?
Well, there's going to be a big gap in between those two times. I saw him play basketball for the first time when he was like 7 or 8 years old at our basketball camp here at DeMatha. The first time I knew he had a chance to be special would have been, you know, when he was like 16 years old going into his junior year. It's a big, pretty big gap there. It was clear that he had a passion for the game when he was younger, but beyond my wildest dreams that I ever imagined him being this good.
We know DeMatha Catholic produces a lot of great players, but just the optics of it, and I know Michael Jordan wasn't always on his varsity team, but a lot of people will scratch their head and say, hey, how was a sophomore not on the varsity team? How do you respond to that, Coach?
There's a couple of factors in that. I think one of the bigger factors is this isn't your normal run-of-the-mill high school, but also, to be perfectly honest, it was clearly a mistake to not have him on the varsity team as a sophomore. I tell the story, a lot of my coaches fought me on that because they felt as though he should have been on the team. And I was pretty much on an island by myself and saying that I thought that it would be in his best interest to play varsity. To play JV. So in hindsight, I definitely was wrong and they were right. I should have listened to them. But obviously, his story's kind of worked out for him. So, would you have it any other way? Yes. But, ultimately, no.
It's awesome. It's like a movie because that doesn't usually happen a lot when a kid's going to be the number one pick in the draft. Just going a little bit further, what was the reason that you gave to those assistant coaches why you weren't going to put him on the varsity at first?
Well, I thought, first of all, we were a pretty good team that year. We were 29-6 by the end of the season. And he, he hadn't really gone through his growth spurt yet. He was still around 5'9", 5'10". He was very good, don't get me wrong, but I just felt like, getting consistent minutes, quality minutes, important minutes. He played on a JV team that started 4 other Division I players, so it's not like he played with, scrubs. He played on, the 4 other starters were all freshmen, but they all went on to be Division I players themselves. So I just felt like just for his maturation, it would be best for him to play as much as possible. I figured he would develop some leadership skills because we did see him as being a potential leader for our program his last 2 years in high school. So I was correct in that. But, again, in hindsight, him being so talented, he should have been on the varsity.
You know him so well as we're talking to Mike Jones, the head coach at DeMatha Catholic. A lot of people here in Philadelphia have never seen him play a second of basketball because he was at Washington last year. How would you describe his game to someone if they never saw him play?
Very versatile. He is somebody that can affect the game in so many different ways. He's somebody who, definitely is an underrated defender. He can score at all 3 levels. He's a playmaker. He will thrive in pick and roll situations. I just really believe that he is somebody that is going to make the Philadelphia fans very, very happy, and they're going to be proud to call him one of their own.
You say he's an underrated defender. Some of the negatives that we're hearing are his defensive play. Clarify a little bit about the defensive player that he is for me.
I can tell you. Obviously, I've been around the game a long time, and I've seen a lot of guys that were not capable defenders. Markelle's a very capable defender. During his years in high school, just 2 short years ago, he guarded some of the best players in the country and did very well against them. So,
Coach, you still there? All right, we're back with Mike Jones. We had a little bit of a disconnection on the phone. But, Coach, pick up where you left off, just talking a little bit about his defensive play and what makes him a really good defender.
Yeah, so like I said, I just think it's something that goes overlooked. I mean, I know everybody gets to see him have the chase down blocks and transition and things like that, but he's been one that's been able to keep guys in front of him. His 6'10 wingspan allows him to have a very long reach, get deflections, you know, kind of hassle ball handlers. And I've seen him do it against very elite talent at the high school level, at elite talent at the USA basketball level of, you know, national team level. So I think he's a very underrated defender and something that has definitely gone overlooked.
You look at the situation that he's walking into in Philadelphia. You have a lot of young stars and a Joel Embiid and a Ben Simmons. You got to think he's walking into a perfect situation, right?
Absolutely. I mean, again, you can't – a lot of people look at the last 6 months, looked at the roster he played with in Washington, looked at, you know, the record that they had in Washington, and I know I've heard some people kind of call into question, you know, whether or not he's a winner and if he has a passion for the game. I think that's absolutely ridiculous, and that is not my biased opinion. I mean, if you look at every part of his basketball career thus far, including Washington, you can't just take the 6 months that he was there and discredit the previous, you know, years and years and years of winning he had. He won here at DeMatha. He won on his AAU team, and he won at the USA basketball level. And it's like everybody forgot about all of that because he had a rough year, you know, during his time at Washington. So, you know, playing with other good players is something he's always done except for the last 6 months. And, you know, playing with Simmons and Embiid and Covington and Sarge, like, I just don't think that he's going to have any adjustment to that at all. I mean, I think he's ready for that.
What has this process been like to see one of your kids? And I know you have a lot of great players at DeMatha Catholic, but good to go number one overall. Just what has this been like with all the trade stuff, and what has your communication been like with Markelle over this process?
Well, the communication with him is, I mean, he's just made it very clear. He just wants to play. He just wants to, like, he doesn't care where he goes. He doesn't care who picks him. He just wants to play. But I do know he's happy that, you know, all of his hard work is starting to pay off. And, you know, I've been to – I had a kid drafted and, you know, Oladipo was number two in 2013, and then Jaren Grant was number 19 in 2015. So I've been to the draft twice before. The only difference is, like, this time we know where he's going. We know when he's going. You know, before it was, you know, you're sitting there and you're waiting. Like, we didn't realize Victor was going to go as high as he did and as early as he did. But it's definitely fun going up this time, kind of knowing that it's going to be over with quick, and we get to be fans.
And it must be nice for you that it's pretty close by to you here in Philadelphia, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. And not only is it close by, but the Philly colors are the DeMatha colors. So,
how about that?
A lot of stuff. Yeah, you know, a lot of the stuff we have, the red, white, and blue we wear here, we get to see him wearing those same colors for the next, you know, for the foreseeable future.
You got to like that. We're talking, wrapping up with Mike Jones, the head coach at DeMatha Catholic. Of course, Coach Markelle Fultz when he was in high school. A thing I love about Markelle, just talking to Rafael Chilius the other day and hearing you speak about him now, is just it seems like he's a very loyal and dedicated player to his craft. Just give me a little bit about how much of a loyal and hardworking player this kid is.
Well, I mean, loyalty. And again, I think, you know, a lot of that just comes from the way he was brought up by his mom. His work ethic is, there is no harder worker when it comes to just working on your game. I mean, but that's a characteristic that he had because he worked that hard when he was in the classroom. He's worked that hard out in the community just doing things that, you know, I just think the Philadelphia community is really going to be pleased with just who he is on the court representing the city, but then also in the community. The kids that will look up to him, just the impact he'll have on just the entire Philadelphia area is going to be incredible. That's just who he is.
The Celtics passing on him, do you think he'll put that a little extra chip on his shoulder and continue to use that as motivation?
If you look at Markelle's history, that definitely is going to be something. He's used everything as motivation to better himself, you know, kind of like Michael Jordan did. So, yeah, I can't imagine it being any other way than, you know, him thinking that, you know what, I was supposed to go to Boston and they chose to go in another direction and they must think that I'm not good enough and I'm going to prove to them that I am. I mean, that's just been his mantra his whole life, and I don't see this man any different.
Coach, since you know him so well and you know him a lot better than we do, just give me a story in your time with interacting with Markelle Fultz that really just describes, you know, that player in person that we were talking to a little bit earlier in this conversation.
Okay. I guess probably the best story I can give you is his junior year. We started doing hot yoga as a team every Friday afternoon. The kids liked it because I think they saw the benefits of it, but they hated it. You know, 105 degrees in the room, you're sweating like crazy. You're not allowed to drink water every time you want to. So we had a situation. The rule was on the team, if you missed a Friday, you had to, before the following Friday, you had to attend a 6 a.m. class. So that was the rule, but nobody really ever really followed it. Well, he missed a Friday because he was doing some extra academic work. And the following Monday, I'd go to class on my own. And when I saw the teacher, the instructor for the class, she was like, yeah, Markelle was here this morning. And I'm like, what? And she was like, yeah, Markelle was here. He said something about he missed Friday's class, so he had to come today. Markelle didn't say anything to me. His mom didn't say anything to me. He just kind of, look, these are the rules. This is what I'm supposed to do. And he went and did it. I had seen him at school that day, never mentioned it to me. He didn't want credit for doing what he was, you know, supposed to do, so to speak. He just did what he was supposed to do, and I think that's kind of him. He follows the rules, he does what he's told, and he works incredibly hard while he does it. So I think that's a story that just epitomizes who he is and what his character is.
You got to love that type of story. Now give me something on court. Give me your favorite on-court memory of Markelle Fultz.
There's so many of them. You know, he's the type of kid that, you know, he'll get a block on one end, make a great pass on the other end, make a defensive stop on one end. You know, he's not going to yell and scream and all of that. That's very rare that he does that. He just kind of goes about his business. Again, that's, you know, the Kawhi Leonard comparison, because he just kind of does it, keeps the same expression on his face. You wouldn't be able to tell if he made his last five shots or missed his last five shots. You know, he's just, that's his demeanor. He's, you know, he reminds me of, like, the city of Philadelphia, like a Rocky. Like, he's the guy that's going to just grind and, you know, put his lunch in the lunch pail, go to work, put the hard hat on, get it done, and then go home and be ready to do it again the next day. And you know, all the success and all the accolades that he's gotten over the past just have kept him humble. And I just think that he's just a great young man. And, again, I don't want to paint the picture of this perfect kid, but, again, I can't find a bad thing to say about him.
Wrapping up with Mike Jones, who joins us right now. How about the rest of the players just having your keen eye on all of basketball and some of the work that you do with our country? Just how about who are some other players in this draft that really do impress you?
All of them. All of them. You know, I'm lucky to be able to sit back and be able to say, hey, you know, I worked with him with USA Basketball. I worked with him at, Nike Skills Academy. Or, you know, and there's so many of these guys I've been around, so I'm happy to see all of them. You know, I'm happy to see Jason Tatum, you know, be a professional. I'm happy to see De'Aaron Fox be a professional. I'm happy to see, you know, Harry Giles, Jonathan Isaac, Jonathan Allen. I'm happy to see all of these guys. Malik Monk, you know, all of them that I've come into contact with over the years. It's just, to me, you enjoy seeing young people be able to achieve their dreams, but obviously being so close to, you know, having a front row seat to Markelle's kind of ascension to being the number one pick in the draft, obviously that just has a special place in my heart.
Since it's so fresh, what are the kids saying at DeMatha Catholic with everything that's happening with Markelle?
It's crazy. The kids love him. So, you know, I was joking with somebody earlier today. We had a sellout crowd show up to our camp the first week of camp, and usually, you know, our camps don't get really packed until July, but you know, the story is Markelle was there when he was 7 years old, so we have more 7-year-olds than we've ever had before. So it's funny. The kids around, the school, the students that go to the school, they're all just so excited. And everybody, like, you know, Markelle was the type of kid that everybody liked, everybody got along with, and he made everybody feel like they were his friends. So when he was a senior and there were freshmen there, like, he would smile, shake hands, speak to, learn names of guys, so that now all of those guys feel like, you know, part of them is getting drafted too. So it's just something he just represents so much.
Well, enjoy Thursday. We're glad to have Markelle coming to Philadelphia. By the way, do you have your suit picked out and you're going to look all nice coming up on Thursday?
Yeah, I definitely I take advantage of the opportunity to get out there and spend time. Hopefully I've got a couple more kids in my program that'll get drafted one day too, and I can wear a suit when they hear their name called. So I definitely have my picked out this time. I look forward to taking pictures and being on social media and all that good stuff.
Well, we're looking forward to following the journey. Hey, Mike, we appreciate it, Coach. Thanks so much, and best of luck the rest of the way.
No problem. Anytime.